Hey, this is
Ari,
and this is Ben, and we're from the band Amoral, and you're watching Metal One. So far.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yesterday especially, in Netherlands. Really, really nice to see the audience getting more and more into the show. So that's why we're here, to, you know, get to play to audiences that don't know us yet. This tour is just 3 weeks, I think 16 or 17 shows, and that's it for this year. And next year is still open, we're not sure. We're going to start working on our new album soon. Hopefully. I have no idea what's going to happen to this album yet. If you know any good promoters in India, let us know. Well, to really get everything out of the album that it's intended for you to get everything out of the album, you need to read the lyrics, really listen to it as a whole piece, the whole 55 minutes, in sequence, preferably through vinyl, with a big, big gatefold sleeve in your hand, and you read the lyrics as you go along, but it is a concept album, there's a story behind the whole album. Which just happened by accident. Really. We started writing songs and they just started making sense as a concept, like similar themes running through the different songs. And also the lyrics I was writing just worked as a big concept story. The main themes of the last album are nostalgia and the third part. Yeah, like the hunger for nostalgia. I just started toying with the idea. Everybody's always talking about the good old days and thinking back of how everything used to be better. The grass used to be greener and the summer used to be warmer. And it's just our mind.
Ice cream was better.
The ice cream tasted better when you were kids. But it's mostly our head. You know how it is. You forget the bad stuff and remember the good stuff. And it's not always the case. So I started to toy with that idea and concept of all the story around this person who just is so fixated on the past and he can't move on and live his life. Like, he's not looking forward or anything, just looking back. Oh, I remember those things. I used to do this, I used to do that. And at the end, it doesn't really work that well for him. That's no way to live your life at all. So that's one of them. And a lot of it had to do with a lot of the guys in the band are 30 now, and I turned 30 around the time of writing the lyrics. So I had a small age crisis going on, which helped with the lyrics. But I'm gonna turn 31 on this tour, actually.
Yeah.
You better bake me a cake or something.
I don't know.
So let's see, next album's gonna be a couple of years. I think the last album before this one is even more mixed. But it really just, if it feels and sounds natural, then like putting acoustic stuff within the same song as Black Metal is, then why not? It's not like we're making a list, shopping list of what we want to have on that one. We need electronic beats, we need Black Metal riffs, we need acoustics, and we need a dance song. And then we force it into it. It's just whatever happens. Actually, it's not that weird once you hear it. People say, like, I've been talking to people like, how can you put this Black Metal beat with clean vocals and acoustic voice with the symphony? Like, but it makes sense once you listen to the album. It's not forced in any way. It's not pre-decided. Just we listen to the demo and think about, oh, maybe we can do something else with this part. Maybe we can go this way. Try to do something we haven't done before.
It's a bit about the fact that it's so dark most of the year, and there has been, of course, the you know, Lordi won the Eurovision Song Contest and everything, so that's kind of what made it big.
It's kind of mainstream, the whole metal scene in Finland now.
It's going down right now, actually, and I think that's a good thing too.
It got too big. Now people are getting a bit bored with it. So I think we're witnessing a decline of metal music in at the moment. Maybe not enough within the bands or the quality, just the popularity of metal going down a bit. But I think it's natural. Things go like this, up and down. So the biggest trend is over now. But yeah, like Ari said, the weather I'm sure had something to do with it. We're not outside every month of the year playing football and having fun.
That you have said a couple of times that when there are good bands in like close to you, you can feel like, dude, I can do that.
The bands inspire each other. So we were kids, we were seeing children of Bodom who listened to the first album. They were 17 years old, so me and you we just thought like, hey, we can do that also. So they're also from Helsinki, close by. Yeah, that's one of the reasons. Just to see that keeps feeding each other, that's part of each other. I've been describing it as a classic rock of the 21st century.
Yeah.
It's still funny.
The joke is that what we think of classic rock is like Led Zeppelin and Pink Floyd, Deep Purple, stuff like that. Bands that have done many kinds of music, like there have been like Led Zeppelin albums that has reggae and really fast paced metal stuff and punk rock stuff. And
same thing with bands like Queen.
Yeah.
I think they're a rock band, but how many different things have they done? Like Bohemian Rhapsodies and operatic stuff, straight up rock and roll. So within the classic rock, I think you can do anything you want.
One?
I don't think there's just one that you can listen to the album and say, oh, these guys can listen to this. I can pretty much say.
I'd go ahead and say Amoral.